Hello, my name is Lourdes Johnson, she, hers, and together with Emily Summers, Katie Martinez, Alice Braille, the leadership team members, and Farrell from the membership committee, are honored to welcome you to our 2023 Be Curator Forum. Thank you very much for joining us. We all work very hard to have a different programming this year. Thank you so much to our hybrid programming committee. We are offering a wonderful event, and we started earlier this year with 2 days of workshops that we hope that you found engaging and valuable in your daily practice as digital archivist, digital curator, practitioner. Next slide, please. The smooth coordination of the 2023 forum would not be possible without the incredible work, time, and dedication of so many people. First, thank you so much to our presenters and attendees. You make this forum what it is by being willing to share your ideas, your experience, and your time with the community. Second, many thanks to those within the BitCurator community, including the Executive Council, Membership Committee, Code of Conduct Committee, Software Development Committee, and others who have contributed to the sustainability and success of this forum. And of course, none of these would be possible without the hard work and steadfast vision of the folks from Educopia who participate in the BitCurator Consortium Forum Committee. Thank you so much to Nancy Adams for being our technical support in overseeing everything related to Eventbrite registration and Zoom. Thanks to Kelly Pendergrast for her work in wrangling all the awesome graphics that you see and for helping us with all our social media and communication needs. And last but certainly not least, Jess Farrell, who keeps us all on track and in good spirits. Jess is behind so much of the planning for this forum and for the BitCurator Consortium in general, and is our point person at Educopia. She is an incredible community facilitator and puts all of her skill into making these events a success. Please join me in a round of virtual applause for Educopia staff. Finally, big thanks to the BitCurator Forum Committee, who is the core group that spends nearly all year planning, developing, and coordinating this event with thoughtfulness and precision. The leadership team this year consisted of myself, Katie Martinez, Alice Braille, Emily Summers, and we were supported by an amazing group of folks, including Elvia Arroyo Ramirez, David Sorella, Brian Dietz, Elizabeth Dunham, Lara Friedman Shetlock, Kelly Phillips, Lori Podolsky, and Kari Smith, who work incredibly hard as forum committee members to put on an amazing forum this year. Please join me in thanking the committee for all of their work.
Hi, I'm Emily Summers, and I'll be doing the land acknowledgement for the forum this year. So, our Big Curator Forum is a hybrid event, and it's likely that you're participating from the traditional homelands of Indigenous people. We invite you to take a few minutes this week and reflect and acknowledge the Indigenous people whose homelands you inhabit. If you're unsure, you can visit nativeland.ca and search your city, town, or address. Our forum committee members acknowledge that we each occupy Indigenous lands. We acknowledge the history of genocide and forced removal from these homelands through colonization. We acknowledge the many diverse Indigenous peoples still connected to these lands and recognize our role in their displacement and marginalization. The land I'm streaming from today, Tuckeronto, the Mohawk word meaning where there are trees standing in the water, has for thousands of years been the traditional land of the Wendat, the Haudenosaunee, the Chippewa, the Anishinaabeg, and the Mississaugas of the Credit. Toronto, as it's now known today, is covered by Treaty 13, also known as the Toronto Purchase, with the Mississaugas of the Credit. Today, this meeting place is still the home to many Indigenous people from across Turtle Island, and as a settler, I'm really grateful to have the opportunity to live and work on this land. In recent months, alongside my colleague Daniela Ansovini, I've been working on an archival description style guide for the U of T Archives. Work on this project has been an opportunity to reflect on the legacy and continued forms of colonialism that surface through language and representation, the history of the university itself, and the ways in which we approach our current work. It has also emphasized how our connections to people and place inform all aspects of our work, and in turn, the depth of our responsibility to attend to these relationships, in particular, those with Indigenous nations. The members of the Forum Committee are acknowledging the peoples whose lands they each currently occupy. We will take a moment on each slide to acknowledge the traditional inhabitants and maintainers of those lands. Thank you. And I'll now hand it over to Katie to talk about the Code of Conduct.
Hello. So in 2019, the BitCurator Forum adopted a community agreement, which has served as a framework for inclusive participation and engagement for each forum since. Now with our third virtual forum, we have to remain mindful about how we engage with others in a virtual space, where it can be so easy for things like sarcasm and tone to be misinterpreted or misread. So this community agreement is adopted from Aorta Collective's anti-oppressive facilitation for democratic process. There are 7 agreements, and I invite folks to read through pages 2 to 3 of the PDF that is shared through the forum website and take a deeper dive into what each of these agreements mean. But for now, I'll briefly read through them. The first 4 listed on this slide, one person speaks at a time, everyone has something to contribute, aim for a more equitable participation, please feel comfortable participating even if you're unsure about terminology. And this one is especially relevant since we have lots of students and early career professionals attending the forum for the first time this year. And be aware and considerate of time, embrace curiosity, and acknowledge the difference between impact and intent. So if we could have the next slide, please. So the how to report violations. The first option is to fill out the report form, which can be accessed through the link that you see on the screen, bit.ly/bcc-coc-report. There are a few key things to know about the report form. First, it allows you to provide as much detail about the incident as you feel comfortable with. It also allows you to report anonymously and or on behalf of violations witnessed or experienced by someone else. And finally, reporters can elect to exclude any member of the Code of Conduct team or other BCC groups from the review process if they would like. The second option is to report via email by writing directly to conduct@educopia.org, which is a shared account that will be regularly monitored by the Code of Conduct team throughout the forum. And the third option, you can email any member of the Code of Conduct team directly via the contact details listed on the report form. Okay, next slide, please. I also wanted to mention that our hashtag is BitCuratorForum. Feel free to use it to amplify all the good things you learn and hear about this week. Next slide, please. Okay, and we also wanted to share that this is our very first year of satellite programming. We are so excited that in-person events are happening in these different cities. And some are already sold out, but please check out the schedule page to sign up for events in your area. And we're really excited to see where this goes. So I will hand things off to Alice.
Hi, all. I'm Alice Prale, she, they, and member of the Forum Leadership Team. So this year we have 2 birds of a feather virtual networking opportunities, which are designed to provide space for people who are self-identify as Black, Indigenous, and people of color, as well as students and new professionals to meet other forum attendees. This year they will take place on Wednesday at 11:30 Pacific, 2:30 Eastern for students and non-professionals. And the birds of a feather for Black and Indigenous people of color is at Thursday at 12:15 PM Pacific, 3:15 Eastern. If you have not yet registered for either of these sessions but are interested in attending, please email nancy@educopia.org to join. Next slide. So like last year, we'll do a great question session, which is scheduled to take place this Thursday at 9 a.m. Pacific, noon Eastern, 5 p.m. British Standard Time. For those of you who have never attended previously, this is a judgment-free opportunity to crowdsource the answers to all of the questions you've been dying to get community feedback on and/or are too embarrassed to ask directly. The way it works is you can use the link on the slides to anonymously submit your questions, and we'll use this time to solicit input from the community. We'll use our automated progressive stack again this year, which prioritizes questions submitted by people self-identifying from historically excluded groups, as well as students and new professionals. You can submit your questions at tinyurl.com/askbcc. This is the fourth year running that we've hosted this session, and it's always an audience favorite. We can't wait to see you there. For more information, can be found at the participant guide at tinyurl.com/greatqguide. Next slide, please. Now I want to thank a number of our sponsors. On behalf of the forum committee, I want to recognize and thank sponsors for their support of this year's forum. We're excited to have two new sponsors and one returning. Their support has meant a lot, morally and financially. It's good to receive a boost from respected peers, and their financial support has allowed us to again offer a $0 ticket option while also maintaining financial viability of the forum. First off, I'd like to thank the Art and Obsolescence podcast, a great podcast featuring conversations with people shaping the past, present, and future of art and technology. The intersection of art, technology, and digital preservation is something that has certainly been discussed at past forums, so I know this will be of interest to many of you. You can listen to the podcast at artandobsolescence.com, Apple Podcasts, or Spotify. Next slide. Thank you also to the Global Archivist LLC. Global Archivist LLC is the partnership of Kari R. Smith and Dr. Nance Y. McGovern. They have combined experience of over 60 years working with archives, records, and cultural heritage by preserving, building capacity, and providing training for the sustainability of digital material. They work with organizations of all sizes to help them reach their goals, and you can learn more about them and their work at globalarchivist.com. And finally, I want to thank Myriad Consulting. Myriad is a returning sponsor, and we are so appreciative of their continuing support. Myriad is a nonprofit consulting and training firm specializing in collections care, digital preservation, digitization, grant writing, and more. Their consulting group is made up of leaders in the cultural heritage field with experience across many institutional settings. You can explore their team and services at myriadconsultants.org. I'll pass it off to Farrell. Thank you.
Thanks, Alice. I'm Farrell, he, him pronouns, and I represent the membership committee. I wanted to take a few moments to plug membership for the BCC or in the BCC. To all our current members and volunteers, thank you for your ongoing support, and apologies if you've heard a little bit of this before. The Big Curator Consortium is an independent, community-led membership association. Our growing community supports practitioners responsible for the curation of born digital materials, especially through the application of free and open source tools like BigCurator. What do we mean by independent or community-led? Well, the BCC is an independent community currently hosted by Educopia Institute, who provides backbone administrative support for the community. But everything that happens is the result of the community deciding to do it and then organizing the volunteers and or budget to make it happen. Financial decisions, strategic direction, public communications, the planning of large events like this one, the community members both make the decisions and carry out the work to make it all come together. The second part of our mission statement notes that we support practitioners doing this work through the application of free and open source tools like the BitCurator environment. This doesn't mean that our members only use BitCurator or even exclusively use free and open source software. Many members use proprietary software in their workflows all the time, but our community doesn't have the power over how those tools are governed and developed or how their functionality evolves. Focusing on open source solutions wherever possible opens up opportunities to contribute to development and feedback in ways that just aren't possible with proprietary solutions. Next slide, please. I'm not gonna run through all the ways to get involved with the BCCNS activities. We don't have time for that today, but there's a link here in the slide for that full list. I basically wanna highlight that regardless of your membership status, there are ways to both keep up with and participate in the activities of the consortium. Next slide, please. If you are affiliated with an organization or an independent who doesn't yet have an institutional membership but are interested in hearing more, the membership committee is happy to have that conversation. The form at this link, bit.ly/BCCinterest, We'll ask a couple of basic questions about you and your organization. And then following the wrap-up of this forum, the membership committee will be reaching out to have a brief call with interested parties about the benefits of membership. Next slide, please. That said, we also realize that institutional membership may be a hard sell for you. The BCC does confer most benefits of membership to individuals who agree to volunteer to a BCC committee. The forum linked here, bit.ly/volunteerBCC, will gather a little bit of information about you and your interests, and then we'll connect you to one or more committees based on those interests. And with that, I'll hand things back to Emily.
I'm really excited to say this. I think I've been waiting all year to hear it. I think we can finally get started with the forum. Let the forum begin. Thanks everyone for joining us, and we really hope that you have a great week.